Hello students, so today we will continue lesson 1, that is the networking concept, and today we will discuss about the types of network. Okay, see, there are 5 types of network are there. PAN, which is called the personal area network. LAN, which is the local area network. CAN, which is called the cluster area network, or also called the campus area network. MAN, metropolitan area network. WAN, wide area network. So these different types of 5 different types of networks are classified on the basis of their coverage area, that how much area, that how much range these different types of networks cover, that how much area it can catch the signals, or how much areas the different types of the computers can be connected over this network. Okay, so we'll discuss in detail one by one. First is the PAN, which is called the personal area network. Now see, this PAN, personal area network, covers a very small network area. It covers a very small network area, that is around 10 meter. So 10 meter area of network is covered in the PAN, which is called the personal area network. So it is used for the communication among devices. So this PAN network, personal area network, why this network we are using? For communication. So this network is used for the communication among devices such as the laptop, mobile phones, PDA, personal digital assistant, or smartphones. This PAN can either be wired or wireless. So this network comes in both category. This network can be prepared with help of the wired media also and the wireless media also. So we use these networks to transfer the files, including emails, calendar, appointments, digital photos and music, whatever the things are there, we can share over this network. Next is the local area network, which covering range is the office building, means one building and one building's entire computer can be connected over LAN. Okay, so all these networks are classified on the basis of its geographical area covered by these networks. So in the LAN, what range of area is covered? One or two building, that is the office building. So in LAN, two or more computers and peripheral devices. Peripheral devices means hardwares like the printers and cameras, speakers, all these are the peripherals, scanner and other things. So in LAN's local area network, more computers, two or more computers and peripheral devices are connected within a small area such as room or an office building. In LAN, computer terminals are physically connected with the wires. In the LAN network, these networks are installed with the help of the wired media, with the help of the cables. So network, computer terminals are physically connected with the wires, and data transmission speed is slow compared to the wide area network. So the speed of data transmission is slow in comparison to the WAN. So here the speed is less in the LAN in comparison to the WAN. Okay, now LAN operated in a small area can be controlled and administered by a single person or an organization. So the LAN in which building it is installed, it is administered by one person or that organization who has owned that local area network, who has installed, who has paid for the LAN network. So that person who is the owner of this LAN network only can administer and control this or devices which is connected to this local area network. Next you see the cluster area network, CAN. CAN is also known as campus area network, and it is comprises of a series of small LANs. So 2-3 LANs are connected, and the collection of 2-3 LAN network is called the CAN, campus area network, cluster area network. Means cluster means here the group of more than 2 LANs. So in the college campus you find many buildings are there. One is the art department, one is the science department, maybe the third one is the engineering department, medical science department. So all these different departments, LANs, are connected with each other with the help of the cluster area network, that is the CAN. So LAN, this network covers an area smaller than the MAN. So the coverage area of CAN network is the less than the MAN. Now next is the metropolitan area network, which is called the MAN. So this MAN is a larger network than LAN. MAN is larger than LAN and it covers entire city around 100 km. It is the covering range of the MAN network. So the most common example of this type of network is the cable operators. So the cable television. So in the cities you find many cable operators are there, and the cable operators let down the cable throughout the city to offer the services of the cable TV. So the help of that cable network, the users, means who are taking the services of the cable TV, they are able to watch the different channels, GTB, Sony and other things. Just only they are paying the monthly fees. Next is the wide area network. So branches of local bank in a city is also connected with the help of the MAN network. In previously many banks are there, or many branches of one bank are connected with each other with the help of the cables. Next is the WAN, wide area network. So this network connects two or more computers located at a distant places, far places. Computers are connected with each other with help of the WAN. WAN we can say or internet. So this covers a large area. Example of the wide area network is the telecom system. So in the telecom system, you see many towers are there with the help of the many BTS station. We are able to make a call from one country to the other country, from one city to the other city. So the users of WAN is limited to a very large organization and government agencies. So wide area network is used by the big agencies, big organizations and the government agencies. And the characteristics of the wide area network is that it requires a public telecommunication media to transfer the data. So they use the public telecommunication media, this is the public network, to transfer the data with the help of the PSTN network, or the many other internet service providers are there today, like the Jio, VA, Vodafone, Idea and Airtel. All these are the internet service providers, which they are called the ISPs. So the best example of the WAN are internet and intranet in the large multinational company. Internet means that is the international network. Intranet means network within an organization, network within a city, that is called the intranet. ATM facility is the example of the wide area network. See, all the ATMs are connected with each other. National and multinational bank customer services. All the banks nowadays, we are availing the services of the internet banking. So that is only with the help of the wide area network. So next is the networking devices. So many networking devices are there. So what are the networking devices? The hardware. Networking devices are the hardware devices used to connect computers or other electronic devices together in order to share the files or resources, like printers or fax machines. Means network devices are the hardware device. Network devices are the hardware device which connect two or more than two computers or two or more than two devices, like the printer, like the fax, to share their resources. So one printer can be shared by more than two computers. So one fax machine can be shared by more than two persons. So one scanner can be shared by more than two computers. So for that purpose, we use the networking devices. Okay. And these networking devices work at different segments of a computer network, performing different tasks. And these networking devices has different functions, and they are used at different segment of the network. Means our network is a large infrastructure, and that infrastructure is divided into many small parts, and each part, that is called a segment, and in each segment some network devices are used to strengthen the quality of the network. Now first networking device is the modem, that is called the modulator demodulator modem. So first networking device is the modem. Which is called the modulator and demodulator. So the use of this modem, I have discussed in the last class about the modem. So modem help us to connect your computer to the available internet connection over the existing telephone lines. So modem is used to connect the computer with the telephone lines, which is the PSTN network. So this modem helps to connect the computer to that PSTN network. So why it is required? Because the PSTN network carries only the analog signals. This is called the analog signals. So the signals carried by the telephone lines, that is called the analog signals, and computer generates only the digital signals, that is the zeros and one. So computer signals are generated like this continuous form, zeros and one. Okay, this signal is called the digital signal. 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. So this is called the digital signals. Analog signals is not a continuous, see, that is called the analog signal. So the telephone lines carry this type of signals and the computer generates this digital signal, and computer also understands only this digital signal. So the modem convert the digital signal of the computer generated by the computer into the analog signal, and then this analog signal carries with the help of the cable over the network, and again that signal reaches to another computer, and again there is the modem. That modem convert this analog signal into the digital signal, and only computer understand this digital signal. Okay, so what it does, modem converts the digital signals of a computer into the analog signals to enable their transmission with the help of the phone lines. At the destination, again the receiving modem further means at the destination end, the computer which receives the signals, again that computer have the modem, and that modem converts the analog signals into the digital signals so that the data can be understood by the receiving computer. So modems are available in two categories, internal modem and external modem. So many computers are there which has inside the CPU, means over the motherboard modem is planted, and some are, and in some computer we use external modem at the back of the CPU too. There is a port available to connect the modem on the motherboard. So an internal modem comes as a separate part that is installed on the PCI peripheral component interconnect slot. So on the motherboard PCI there, peripheral connects interconnect slot is there, and on that slot we connect this external modem. Okay, peripheral component interconnect PCI. So PCI slot is there and external modems are connected on that PCI. So after that there is the hub and other networking devices. So this is all for the today's students. In the next class we'll discuss the remaining networking devices like the hub, switch, repeater, router, gateway, bridge. All these are the networking devices which are installed at different segments of the network. So today we will discuss about the one networking device, modem, modulator and demodulator. So this is all for today. Thank you for your kind attention.